So, if you want your song to be on our station, submit it to tim@worldviral.tv or chad@worldviral.tv.
Hack it or axe it. Send in your submissions.
It's turned on.
It's a joke.
Yeah, it's like 16 minutes. All right, Music Buzz Live. We're back here in Studio A. My name is Moose. We got Bella Rage, Will Kilduff, Chad Drew, Chad H somewhere. We got a full studio back in the booth as well. This is Hack It or Axe It, brought to you by Colorado Harvest Company. We got six songs tonight. Three artists.
All right.
That's exciting.
Three artists, six songs.
Very diverse.
Yes.
Let's check out the
they're
first
one. They're not all going to be rap? Like
no, they're not. Only two. Only two raps.
Okay.
Yeah.
We had like a week, a couple weeks ago. It was just all rap.
I think it was last week, and we were all just like, we don't want any more rap.
I wasn't in the rap mood. Yeah. Dude. I was like,
The last time I was on here,
they just
was,
weren't great rap songs.
It was Linkin Park. I was supposed to get you all Linkin Park shirts after
that. That's right.
Show.
I forgot about that. Where's our shirts, Bella?
I know.
Damn it.
I know, such tease. There's Linkin Park shirts. Gosh, I'll get them signed for you
first. I totally wanted them so bad.
All I ever wanted was a signed Linkin Park shirt. Yeah. You know, like, God.
And then it was just a big
I wouldn't even wear it because I wouldn't want to mess it up, you know? I'd just frame it and put it on my wall.
It would be kind of one of those art moments.
Yeah.
Get a picture with Chester, like, sitting next to it or something. Yeah just for you.
Pretty epic.
Yeah.
Actually,
that'd be about it. I hang that like right next to my Nickelback. You know what I mean? Like,
I'd put it right next to the sliding glass door to my balcony because that way it's one step closer to the edge.
and it would be about to break. Therefore.
Oh my God, you guys, swing now with that
swing.
That was pretty wavy right there, guys.
Let's see what we've got this week on Hack It or Axe It.
Yeah, segue.
All right, are we ready?
Okay. Here comes the first tune.
Look at them working back there.
No, they're so
they're doing
cute.
Such a great
little
job.
Worker bees.
Working. Such a great job.
Makes me want honey.
That was the background music. I totally would hack that.
We already hack it.
We need to hack
it. We hack that one.
I love talking over that song more than any other song.
It's got a long intro.
Okay.
Oh,
there's some digital stuff going on. Meet more meat.
All we have left here is a chainsaw. We're stranded in a prison of a broken base. And the seasons are forgotten and lit in the way.
I mean, I kind of dig it.
I like the voice is very like consistent too.
Confident.
I don't know. I think his voice is kind of weak. I gotta say, guys.
I think in the entire element.
I wanted to hear the change because if he's gonna do this genre.
Yeah, true.
I'm gonna hold him to the CT standard.
Whenever he's
you know,
very
it's not even close.
What's the question?
Just say that I don't think his voice is very strong. I think he sings all right, but I don't think his voice is that strong.
Are you saying I'm a snob?
No, I'm saying that
you are.
You're better than him, way better. And if I'm going to hear this genre, then I want to hear it as good as you sing it, not this Scott Stapp kind of wannabe guy.
Omniism's Chris Thomas back in the booth, guys. Omniism's
I'm not saying that. He's not as good as the genre that he's singing.
We've got another song by these guys. Let's check
it
out.
Let's see if it's better.
I like that one enough. I think that he missed on that scream.
Trying to be honest
that
about
it. Upper octave register. His voice is not strong in that level.
Okay, guys, next song. The more lower.
Let's see if he pulls this one off. I'll give him a chance. Yeah.
I like this guitar intro.
Prove me wrong, brother.
Much better.
Much more radio friendly.
That fits him way more.
That fits him, way better. Definitely.
A little better vocal performance.
Yeah, definitely better. I think this is a better song.
Much better.
For sure.
If this is one, you know.
But let's see if he's got the power. You know it's going
to
change.
Will's still not impressed. Will's hard to please here. He's been to Jamaica.
No, I'm with this song so far. I want to just... This one's much better.
Yes.
I mean, I'd hack this song.
Yeah?
Yeah, dude.
Oh, there's the bass. Oh, see? Right there,
I just
me.
Don't know, man. I mean, I would hack the song. I would still... This song's got me vibing, you know, but... Like,
that
I just...
Part.
It's like, dude, we grew up listening to, like, Soundgarden and shit.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's like, if you're gonna do that bass change, you better come with
it. Strong. Yeah. Like, vocally, definitely.
I mean, it's got Herman's Hideaway written all over it.
That's like simultaneously endearing and like.
It's got a good vibe. I feel like they almost need to master it. Just a little
bit. I think. Does anybody know where this band is from?
No,
they're
I'm
from
not
here. I'm pretty sure. Is this Dog Day King?
Yes.
Timber Band.
Yeah.
I would give their live show a chance because it could be that their live show is not captured on the production.
They're good. They do a good job here.
Yeah.
But.
Well, any true artist does know their vocal range or vocal range capabilities, and unless you're going to go into a higher level of training, keep it within that range so that way your music stays consistent and that's what people will pull in, you know? That's what causes people to hack your music is that consistency and that vocal quality. So know your limits and don't go past it, but embrace those limits and you'll get more in there, you know what I mean?
You'll break them.
Spoken like
exactly.
A true master.
Brilliant.
I know
that's exactly
music.
It. Like
I know music.
Good music. Keep doing it.
Keep doing it. Keep working because you're doing a great job. Right. But you know, you got to either go gusto and invest in that vocal capability to get in that higher octave range or just keep it at that low, familiar place because you're doing a great job.
Yeah. Really great melodies, though. Like,
yeah.
Really cool notes.
Yeah, good riffs.
They've
good
kept
music.
My attention.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, see, yeah. Even though I think this is the only time we've actually debated this far into the song
might
genre
be, without
as
going off
to,
topic.
Like, an accent or hack it
there you
situation.
Go.
Like,
yeah, usually we're like,
yeah, are we hacking it or what?
Yeah, I'm hacking it, dude. I'm going to hack it.
I hack it.
All right.
Yeah, for sure.
I give this one a hack, yeah.
It's up to you all, dude. That was my
right.
Vote.
Dog Day King is hacked.
Yeah.
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 If for any reason the intro,
one.
The intro
yeah.
Is great.
Yeah.
Intro.
Yeah. Here's the next one.
Good guitar work.
Here it is, right here.
Terry, you a fool for this.
Nothing
matters.
Look, yeah.
Nothing matters if it don't to you. Nah, or with whatever you bought, if it's making cheddar or something better. Don't front to groove.
Sounds
we ain't
like
gotta
them.
Act. Just show me the pussy facts. You did not book your evening with another fool. Money speaks volumes. Right. Broke niggas be silent. You don't want these problems, bro. We can be violent.
I don't know.
Can you turn up the bass a little bit?
He's like Chris Knapp.
Lights on. Pipe strong. So
he's got a cool voice.
Chad's all about that bass, not treble.
Team high as
the
bat at the peak of night.
Long
rips
like
a
bitch find the right thong for a fuck. Roll with
flow.
Us in
his
drugs, parties and beats in the cells, ballers and leaders with sluts crossing the streets.
I
think it
could
get our party moving,
for
sure.
I think it could, yeah.
These hoes can't smoke with me.
I don't fuck with the rubbers cause I like it raw. Talk like nothing fucking matters. I pull up to the club with the open bar tab like nothing.
I like it, dude.
Yeah, it's actually pretty catchy.
Yeah,
dude, I'm with it.
Got some catch to
it. He's like got that
yeah.
Entitled bitch voice.
Right
sound
now.
Pretty good.
Who is this now?
Bitch, we rip, come out, all right. Now I don't even know this place, but you're macking out potential of my baby
Legato.
Face.
Terry Legato, that's right.
Nice.
You soaking up my chin and my panties taste.
Now I have that one little vibe, you know, sometimes. If you're throwing a good party and you just need some music going, you know, maybe conversational-wise, you know, get the conversation going somewhere. It's got a good beat.
They don't tell the pastor. Cause tonight, nothing fucking matters. Fuck with the brothers cause I like it raw, dog. Like nothing
fucking
matters.
Yeah.
I want to hear the dude rap again.
Yeah, I know. I want to hear it go throwback.
All right,
what do you guys think?
I hack it. I think it's good.
I hack it.
This is hackable. It's got a place. This has got some Motel Minute place in it somewhere.
Right. Motel Minute, for sure.
That hook? For sure.
I'm in the spot. Oh, there you go. All
right, we got another one by these guys, too. Let's listen to the other one.
I like that one.
He's popping and locking. Chris knows how to twerk.
Oh.
She's got a pretty voice.
It sounds like that chick that sings on that Eminem song.
Yeah, I could hear
Rihanna.
Her.
Rihanna?
Is that Rihanna? Who it is?
Yeah.
It sounds like Rihanna.
Yeah.
I definitely like the other one.
I would have liked this if it were EDM, if she went right into an EDM funk mode. Like, her voice, the first girl, would have been proper for some EDM bounce.
Yeah, I'm not digging this one. I like the other one a lot better.
Yeah,
this would work over like a porno compilation.
Yeah, this is more of like, yeah, something like that. That'd be precise. You've been doing some studying?
I totally like the flow of the other one way better.
Yeah, the other one was way more catchy, way more upbeat, way better for the radio.
Sure. Yeah, I mean, I'd have to be able to hear the lyrics to make a quality call on this, but I dig the other track.
I'd axe this one.
I've been catching some of the lyrics, and they're nice, but I just don't think it's like show appropriate.
Like, this voice, like that singing voice, that's beautiful, but I want to hear that on some EDM track.
Next one.
Yeah, and that's like,
all right,
that's not gonna happen.
All right, next song.
You're like, this isn't about music right now.
I didn't hear what the lyrics were even about. I couldn't catch a grip.
I was only catching a little bit of it. Yeah.
Love acoustic.
If it's done right.
Yeah, definitely.
Can't hold someone's attention forever in a song. You can't hold someone.
So it sounds like, you know, like a movie scene,
yeah,
like for sure.
Like something about Mary
like
Band,
yeah,
but like with real lyrics.
Yeah, or 500 Days of Summer.
Yeah.
It should be in that movie.
Precise. It's so sentimental already, it feels.
If there's a whistle solo, then like.
Yeah. Or a little harmonica.
Right.
You know?
Seriously. Yeah. It's beautiful.
Nice little.
I kind of feel like skipping to it, dude.
Just when I like.
Reminds me of that song.
I don't like it. I don't like it.
You're not feeling it? All right.
I'm not feeling it either.
Let's try song number two.
I'm with it.
I love it.
Oh, Will likes it.
I'll hack it. You guys can axe it.
Sushi?
I'll take this one.
It could be sushi, dude. It could.
Is this the other one?
We could probably choose between them.
Maybe so.
The whistle.
There it is.
Yeah,
there it is. Will's already sold.
You called it.
We haven't even got into the verse yet.
You called it on that one. You love her. Oh, look.
Don't just keep
so sweet. Feeling
down and unsure. It's absolutely charming.
It's just so sweet.
Charming. It like
is.
Open the door.
Yeah.
It's sushi playlist
it's
for like
gentleman.
For sure.
Playlist, yeah,
for sure.
Not for the don't show, but I love. Yeah, I forgot we have to decide for the show.
It's not really show.
For the show, axe it, but send me everything to my email. Like Chris, hook me up.
I'll forward you the album.
Yeah, for sure. I love
feel
it.
Like riding my bike in Boulder.
Yeah, listening to it in Boulder works out perfect.
It takes me back further than that.
It does.
You know,
it's really
it takes
classic.
Me back like further than hippie days. It's like don't back when you can just have a fishing pole and go wade out into the middle of the river and fish.
See,
you know,
like
my
like,
gold, my yeah. gold.
What's
yeah,
that?
Nick.
What's that movie where? They're in like the, it's like a black and white movie and the people get stuck in it and there's only like the two streets.
Yeah, like Pleasantville.
Yeah. It's like Pleasantville.
Yeah, I would
you know,
see that.
They're like, why do you, all the firefighters do is rescue cats out of trees
or
because
that,
there's no
exactly,
fires.
That's what Truman Show.
The Truman Show, the Jim Carrey movie. That's what I was thinking too. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, those are the... Yeah, those nice old days when there was like romance and stuff.
Well, but see that's the artificial nostalgia because like the good old days were just shitty too. They just people remember them through songs like this.
Right, you know? Through Black and White, through I Love Lucy.
Yeah,
sorry. Yeah, that's how we remember.
It had to end.
TV.
Oh,
I know
over.
That I'm gonna get resistance from the booth in that.
Did you guys turn it off or the song was over?
Resistance.
Take a guess.
You turned it off.
Yeah, dude.
I think she played the
I
whole
will
thing.
Never tell.
She liked it.
Oh,
not everyone likes Andy Williams and shit like that, like me, dude. So.
All right. Well,
I bet Chris was dying.
I mean,
there,
I like the song. I know. I can't think of a time when we would jam
point.
It on the
if you
show.
Guys,
though.
If you guys are axing it for show purposes,
yeah,
I mean, you're not going to
sure.
hear argument from me.
Exactly.
That's the only reason why
I would say.
Yeah. It's a great song.
Great job, guys. I like your record, and I'll listen.
It's one guy. His name's Thomas Hine.
Thomas Hine.
He emailed it to me this morning.
Good job, for sure. I like that.
Well, Thomas, great stuff, man.
Thomas, good, good timing. Chris didn't have a microphone.
Nah,
good timing.
It's okay. Not for the show, but for our iPods, definitely.
They're not digging it back in the booth.
No, dude. Of course not. Of course not.
They hate us, man. They hate us because we prolong everything.
All right, what's next then?
Yeah, is there more music?
What's
is there
next?
One more?
No,
that's
Boothers.
It. That's it.
Oh,
but there is videos.
It?
Show the videos.
Let's get the videos up in this.
There's
beast.
Tonight's video theme was fuck everything.
I like that.
That's a great theme, dude.
Ew.
Yeah.
I'm very proud of you
watch
for that,
that language.
One.
I really
fuck
tried.
That's awesome. In a peace and loving time with a great holiday
I know,
coming
we
up
just
next
had,
week.
We
fuck
had
everything.
That. Yes, we had that beautiful music.
You know,
fuck
everything.
Everything.
It's like,
that's
you know,
like a
nothing
punk
really
song.
Matters, and fuck everything embodies that, right?
Yeah.
Really
no, it's matters. Like a happy fuck everything.
Yeah, it's like yeah. Fuck everything.
It's not like a fuck you fuck everything.
It's not like fuck everything. It's like fuck
like
everything.
It's like a fuck everything. This is awesome.
Wasn't trying to really.
I like it that way. Yeah. Fuck everything. This is awesome.
So here's your video.
There's two.
Uh-oh.
We can't, can we can't see him.
No, no, everything's black him. Here.
Hi.
Uh-oh.
Hi. This is Loretta Jenkins, and oh I got another PSA for you, I reckon. I just want to say, look, I know I'm a hard pill to swallow. But, hey,
what's going on here?
Just choke on it, okay?
Yeah!
And again, I know I'm not everybody's cup of tea, and I that's fine.
She's just rocking her bra.
She is just rocking her bra.
She's owning it though. She,
that's
that fuck everything.
Great,
right
man.
There.
Killer, though.
I love her.
And,
I love
and
her
I just
want
to say, just love yourself and fuck everything.
Look at the decorations in that house, dude. Like that. Look at that. Look at that painting behind
I hope
her.
That learned you something.
That's awesome.
Oh, she's, oh, I love her.
All right, so that was that one.
I would make.
Now the
make
next
that.
One is a little more upbeat.
That's awesome. That was
the last. This one's not so methed out.
She was just you drunk. Yeah. She was yeah, just drunk, was old drunk. Lady.
Sometime in her life, maybe, but not at that point.
Yeah.
Fuck
that, fuck you, fuck me, fuck rap, fuck her, fuck him, fuck them. Matter of fact, fuck everything, fuck everything, fuck everything. And yo, fuck this, fuck that, fuck you, fuck me, fuck
that. Didn't
rap,
they do a Butthead
her,
or a South
him,
Park dude where they counted how many times they said fuck in the.
Yeah.
Fuck everything. And yo, fuck that job that you're working right now. Fuck the manager, the one to tell you to pipe down. Fuck everybody in the whole situation. You're too skimp for a fucking vacation. We got a Mickey Mouse shirt on.
Need to meet the signs
in between the lines. No wonder they don't give a grade A shit about your pay slip when it's basic.
Oh, but that's profit. I'm basically robbing. I know that clothing company that's not actually Disney is just but it's still ain't enough, but they be killing your boss. What you wanna do is live your life, right? But you're living week to week and money tight to your body. Life's like a game you play but never win. If there's a god, fuck him and fuck everything. Yo, fuck this, fuck that, fuck you, fuck me, fuck rap,
I mean,
fuck her.
There's some angst in there, huh?
Yeah, dude.
It definitely didn't take him a long time to write the hook, but the other part. Fuck everything.
No, I mean, lyrically, yeah. He can flow. I don't. I'm not wild about the beat.
Yeah, I would listen to him if you know.
I mean, and like,
I'd
like to hear a song of his that doesn't have like "fuck" as every word because
yeah,
he can flow. I mean,
yeah.
What you hugging for?
Quince in that thing and a thong. And maybe a little bit less nasally. He's young enough to maybe.
He
let
definitely
balls
listened
drop
to Eminem a lot
yeah.
when he was young.
Yeah.
Right?
I'm wondering if he's the one that actually masters his own tracks or like does he work with somebody else for the track.
He could be like
aspect.
15 too.
Right.
He's like 17.
Probably. I don't know.
He keeps moving his hat around. He can't quite.
Yeah,
yeah I like this.
Very...
I like this move right here.
I like that one. Better that's great.
This one.
He's
when
good at
that.
Being on camera. He's captivating the audience. It's the robot.
Like, if I were a rapper, this is
that's
how
the
I
one?
Would rap.
Tim, I'm going to do that in my next video. Now.
Yeah.
That's my
do it on
like
screen all day today.
Muppet.
Yeah, or the...
I'll do it on stage on Saturday.
There you go.
And the, like, I dig the video. I think the video is cool. Like, you know, it's like using what you got to make a pretty cool video.
Yeah, very low budget.
Yeah, I mean, but it works. You know, it's guerrilla style. I mean,
I mean, if you happen to be like walking by while they were filming this video, and like, why is that guy saying fuck so much?
I'd probably be like, can I be in your video?
Yeah, and then right, started right, back to the floor.
You could really bring in this like we're in all the background.
You could really
stand there and just stare at him.
Just run up and be like, hey, fuck you, fuck you, and then run off.
Man, we could have made your video. Next all right, time.
That was tonight's Hack It or Axe It.
Yay.
Fun one as always. Not stick bad. Around. We got Would You Rather coming up, and then we're going to sign off. Don't go nowhere.
All right. Fuck you, fuck that. Dude.
Viral TV is brought to you.
I finally found the guitar, and it fit with me so well. And, you know, I've just learned to love it, and it's something I do every day.
We are the Mile High Seamsters. We're a nonprofit organization with our partner organization, Optimus Youth. We support youth musicians and school music programs.
I actually started music about 7 years ago in orchestra. And ever since then, I've been interested in the guitar and started about 5 years ago. And it's always been basically, like Kate said, my outlet. And there's really nothing else I can take my energy out on.
I'm a teacher, and so I've seen a lot of how music has benefited my students, especially the kids who struggle in school.
Right.
That's huge, and they need to have those opportunities. It's a way for us to get our youth to, you know, kind of a mentoring sort of position where we can keep them interested and involved and bring the next generation into our fold, so to speak.
We've been doing a quarterly event series that's family-friendly, all-age events at Herman's Hideaway. Get kids up on a big stage, let them see what that's like. We also have a singer-songwriter series for elementary school students and an ongoing musical instrument drive. We recently donated quite a few instruments to DPS. We also raised over $3,000 at our last event in December, and those funds have been designated for Denver Public School music programs.
There was no program like this available. I mean, if I had the opportunity to play on the stage at Herman's Hideaway when I was 12 years old, 13 years old, my life path would have been completely different. Imagine having those 11 years of growth underneath your feet, but also with positive adult role models that guide you through the process.
Check us out at milehighscenesters.org or contact us at milehighscenesters@gmail.com. We'd love to hear from you.
If you're getting high in Colorado today, enjoy it.
Colorado Harvest Company. Colorado Harvest Company. Colorado Harvest Company.
Right, Music Buzz Live. We're back for our final segment of the evening. We want to thank all our sponsors. We got CT out here in the main room.
What's up?
We had to bring him out for the last.
Got some badass interns in the booth, man.
Yeah, pretty rad. And not only that, but they're very attractive as well.
Good
job, sirs. Good job.
You don't mind.
Thanks.
Jacqueline and Liz.
No, it helps. It helps. You know, always make your work somewhere you want to go. Not somewhere you regret.
Solid advice.
You're going to be doing some cool things.
Oh, I've got some good things coming up. I don't have anything solid right now that I can let out like or leak, you know, but it's going to be
exciting.
Pretty big.
We'll
yeah,
keep following her on social.
Yes.
Ooh, follow me Bella on the social media. @disco_Bella on Instagram, of course. Twitter, it would be @Bella_Rage. And... yeah, Bella Rage on Facebook. So check it out, and you'll just keep up with the updates. Definitely.
Very cool.
Bella Rage.
Right on. And next Wednesday, we got our 420 party at Herman's, and down here we're throwing our second compilation album release party.
It's going to be a blast.
Yeah.
I'm stoked, definitely.
Guys. We're packing them in.
Yeah, serious. Next time we're in here, we'll have CDs in hand.
We're going to have like 50 people in here with CDs.
It's going to be rad.
It's going to be an amazing event. Yeah, I'm pretty stoked about it. That's been up on my social media as well. So trying to get everybody to come out, check it out. So have some fun with us next Wednesday.
Cool. We got the Medina Grooves coming in studio on Tuesday.
And
Tim Cohen on Wednesday.
It's going to be
Tim
our
Cohen
musical
on Wednesday.
Guest.
We got Texas Hippie Coalition coming in next week.
Oh, my. That's a big one.
All we do is hold it down.
Hold
you know
it
what I'm saying?
Down in Denver.
303. Shit, bitches.
303.
All right. So,
thanks, Colorado Harvest Company.
What segment is this?
Our good friend Chuck Montero has given us the Would You Rather questions for the week, starting with this one.
This is always scary.
Would you rather see Colorado legalize all illicit drugs including heroin, crack, and ecstasy, or legalize the sale of full-strength beer and wine in grocery stores?
Beer and wine. I think people would be much more responsible with that. Yeah.
Yeah, you're going to put all the...
Yo, let me get my crack, yo. Let me get...
Yeah,
let me get
my... like, doing an experiment. Is
did
it
I miss
Spain?
The 5 o'clock free crack giveaway?
With the drugs?
Somewhere in Europe, they've legalized all drugs, and
right.
they're like...
Well,
they're trying to
they...
make it... that way,
if
but.
They make it smart where they're offering help because they legalize it and then they know what the population is that is actually consuming that said drug,
yeah.
and then offer a treatment plan according to that
do,
aspect.
So
yeah.
Tax that shit.
I mean, that way
yeah,
you,
tax it, you know,
I mean, they're not
like,
going to sell it, but at least
running, but, no.
we don't need all these non-violent drug offenders in jail.
Yeah.
Oh, precisely.
Oh, you want your smack?
No.
Well, guess what?
I'm
going to tax
that
shit.
Al Capone. Beer, dude. We're like the mecca of beer, like microbrew. So there's
definitely.
No reason why we don't have full strength beer.
Right.
Well,
right.
the reason why we don't sense. Is because that would immediately put all this independently owned liquor stores out of business. That's the only reason why there's
marketability,
no
marketability profit.
So
margins.
I would vote no on that
right.
bill.
I don't know. I kind of
you're killing small business and giving it to corporations.
All right, Tim.
Fuck that shit.
All right,
fuck
Tim.
That.
That's just my take.
That's what Tim says. Damn it. Gotta go. With
sorry, I'm
he's
a bleeding heart liberal. would you rather do bong hearts with bong hits with Public Enemy or Kiss?
That's a good one.
Public Enemy.
Public Enemy's gonna
yeah.
be in town.
Yeah.
I'd
is this
go
a gravity
with,
bong?
I'd go with Kiss.
Yeah,
yeah
gravity
Kiss.
Bong.
Kiss would be.
Just because, yeah.
Public Enemy, though, that's like your old school rap. You're going to be like
yeah.
feeling the most real. Like you would hashtag Snoop that shit.
Yeah, that's a possibility because you can go see him at Public, at us. Where are they playing?
They're playing at City Hall, right?
City Hall, yeah. So we can go, we can do that and
yeah.
then hit up
and
Kiss.
And then go after
Kiss.
Kiss.
Yeah.
yeah.
All right, we'll double whammy that. 420 that bitch.
Bong rips all around.
Hashtag yeah. Snooped.
Would you rather? It's just basically like, can I get both?
Let's do both.
Would you rather have sex in a treehouse or in the Mesa Verde cliff house?
Ooh.
Cliff house, because then it's like a cliffhanger.
No,
but
then
would
you're
you
fucking
come?
Up sink. Sink.
Yeah,
it's like
would you
good
ever?
Vibed land, dude.
Yeah, you're like,
I feel like the secret. Yeah, the risk is much less in a treehouse. Like, you're not going to go to prison if
that's
you get caught.
Therefore, it's not as fun either.
Yeah.
It's true.
Yeah.
True.
Dude, they have that show, The Treehouse Masters, and there's some pretty badass
oh,
treehouses,
they are,
dude.
They
so.
Are kind of beautiful.
Treehouses have come a long way
they've
since I was a little
you
kid.
You could even play dress up if your treehouse looked like
that's
a
Swiss Family
movie.
Robinson,
yeah.
bitch. Suck my dick. What? I'm all gangster.
That's prairie style.
All right, we'll
you
do.
You can wear a bonnet.
We'll do one more here. Would you rather have sex in a hot tub full of leeches or in a garden full of bees and wasps?
Oh, fuck that shit.
Wow. Bees and wasps, dude. Bees and wasps, dude. I don't want to have some shit sitting there sucking on my blood and all that
ooh,
shit.
Yeah, I think
yeah,
I'd go with
yeah.
that one,
you
too.
You could die
I mean,
either way, though.
One's more lubricated, you know, because all that Benadryl isn't going to help you, you know.
You'll probably yeah. get in, with the leeches, you'll probably go into DMT mode where you're just like,
I mean, I think either way, I probably would not...
I would not
be
want
feeling
that.
It.
Yeah.
Which one's more likely to give you the to have the transmitted diseases going back and forth?
Like definitely the leeches.
The
leeches
for
yeah,
sure.
Yeah.
That would be like death for sure. Yeah,
it'd be
that's
hard to
not
actually
good.
Do the performance of sex.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Going on.
So we're all going with dry Benadryl,
Benadryl.
Sex or what?
Vaseline
safety,
covered
safety
all over your body.
First. safety
oh, Chuck
first,
Montoro.
Safety first.
All right. Well, thank you, Chuck. That's been tonight's show. We'll see you next week for our 420 party.
That should be
same fun. Time, same place.
420. Music Buzz Live, bitches.
Represent, yo.
All right. Good show.
Good show. Good job.
Broadway. Your favorite independent anti-corporate venue featuring Westward's best patio. Now serving award-winning food. From metal to jazz to hip-hop, Herman's Hideaway has something for everyone. And if you want to book your act at Herman's Hideaway, email booking@hermanshideaway.com or call 303-777-2535. There's only one venue, family-owned and operated for over 50 years, holding it down in Denver. Go to hermanshideaway.com for more information and show listings.
should have seen from the very start how you like to play, play with my heart. But you should have known this heart, it don't lie.